Hi students, today we discuss atoms. Now, in atoms first we discuss Dalton's atomic theory. Dalton's atomic theory, according to Dalton scientist, here all elements consist of a very small invisible particles. According to Dalton scientist, here all elements consist of very small invisible particles. That are called what? Atoms. Now, atoms of same element are exactly same, and atoms of different elements are different. Here means what are atoms? Invisible particles. Every element, prati moolakam chala kanipichinatvanti kanal kaligi untundi, aa kanal ne manam atoms antam. Ikkada oka element ki ee atoms of same element are exactly same. ఇక్కడ ఆటమ్స్ అన్నీ ఒక ఎలిమెంట్లో ఆటమ్స్ అన్నీ సేమ్ ఉంటాయి. డిఫరెంట్ ఎలిమెంట్స్కి ఆటమ్స్ అన్ని డిఫరెంట్గా ఉంటాయి. దట్ ఈస్ డాల్టన్స్ ఆటమిక్ థిరీ. ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ థామ్సన్ ఆటమిక్ మోడల్. అకార్డింగ్ టు థామ్సన్ సైంటిస్ట్ హియర్ ఎవ్రీ ఆటమ్ ఈజ్ యూనిఫామ్లీ పాజిటివ్లీ చార్జ్డ్ స్పియర్ ఆఫ్ రేడియస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆర్డర్ ఇయర్ 10^-10 meters. ఇక్కడ ఆటం యొక్క వ్యాసార్థం 10^-10 meters. ఆర్డర్ ఇయర్ ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ ఇయర్ రేడియస్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ ఆటమ్ ఈస్ 10^-10 meters అండ్ ఇన్ విచ్ ఎంటైర్ మాస్ యూనిఫామ్లీ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్. ఇక్కడ మాస్ మొత్తం యూనిఫామ్గా డిస్ట్రిబ్యూట్ అవుతుంది అండ్ నెగటివ్ చార్జ్డ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఎంబెడెడ్ ర్యాండమ్లీ. ఇయర్ దీస్ ఆర్ నెగటివ్లీ చార్జ్డ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్. Now, anyhow, total atom is here, it is neutral. Tatasthanga untundi, oka atom anedi tatasthanga untundi. Ikkada manaku mottham manaku Thomson scientist prakaram ee atom anedi entidi positively charged sphere, dhanavesham unnatundi oka golam, deentlo electrons anni random ga ikkada manaku embedded ayi untayi. In this we discuss now. సో ఎనీ హౌ ఆటమ్ ఈజ్ ఎలక్ట్రికలీ న్యూట్రల్. అంటే ఎలక్ట్రికలీ న్యూట్రల్ మీన్స్ వాట్ ఇట్ ఇది విద్యుదావేశపరంగా ఇది తటస్థంగా ఉంటుంది. నా లిమిటేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ థామ్సన్ ఆటమిక్ మోడల్ ఇయర్ దిస్ థామ్సన్ మోడల్ ఇట్ కుడ్ నాట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ద ఆరిజిన్ ఆఫ్ స్పెక్ట్రల్ లైన్స్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్ అండ్ అదర్ ఆటమ్స్. హైడ్రోజన్ యొక్క స్పెక్ట్రల్ లైన్స్ ఇది ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేయలేదు. అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇట్ కుడ్ నాట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ లార్జ్ యాంగిల్ స్కాటరింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్. ఇక్కడ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ స్కాటరింగ్ కూడా ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేయలేదు. ఇవి థామ్సన్ ఆటమిక్ మోడల్ యొక్క లిమిటేషన్స్. అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ రుదర్ఫర్డ్ ఆటమిక్ మోడల్. నా అకార్డింగ్ టు రుదర్ఫర్డ్ యు నో దట్ రుదర్ఫర్డ్ ఆల్ఫా స్కాటరింగ్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ ఆన్ ది బేసిస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ రుదర్ఫర్డ్ మేడ్ ఫాలోయింగ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్. వాట్ ఆర్ దట్? Entire positive charge and almost entire mass of the atom is concentrated at its center in a very small tiny region of the order 10^-15 meters. That is called what? Nucleus. Here, according to Rutherford scientist, total positive charge, atom ku unnatundi positive charge mottham mass, atom almost empty, and entire positive charge, atom ku unnatundi dhanavesham, దాని యొక్క మాస్ మొత్తం ఒక స్మాల్ రీజియన్లో మొత్తం కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ అవుతుంది. దాన్నే మనం ఆ టైనీ రీజియన్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్డర్ హియర్ టోటల్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆటమ్ అండ్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ ఈజ్ కాన్సన్ట్రేటెడ్ ఎట్ సెంటర్ ఇన్ ఏ వెరీ టైనీ రీజియన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ 10^-15 meters ఈజ్ కల్ వాట్? న్యూక్లియస్. న్యూక్లియస్ ఆటమ్ ఆర్డర్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ 10^ ఈజ్ వాట్? ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ స్పెరికల్ రేడియస్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ 10^-10 meters. బట్ ఇయర్ న్యూక్లియస్ రేడియస్ ఆఫ్ మచ్ ఇయర్ 10^-15 meters. 10^-15 meters. అండ్ అకార్డింగ్ టు రుదర్ఫర్డ్ సైంటిస్ట్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఇయర్ నెగటివ్లీ చార్జ్డ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ రివాల్వ్ అరౌండ్ ద న్యూక్లియస్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ ఆర్బిట్స్. ఈ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ అన్నీ న్యూక్లియస్ చుట్టూ డిఫరెంట్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్లో రివాల్వ్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి. అండ్ టోటల్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ ఆఫ్ న్యూక్లియస్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు వాట్? టోటల్ నెగటివ్ చార్జ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్. So that's why anyhow total atom is overall is neutral. Neutral means what? Tatasthanga untundi. Ante oka atom lo here న్యూక్లియస్ లో ముందు ఆటమ్ యొక్క పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్, ఆటమ్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ మాస్ మొత్తం సెంటర్లో కేంద్రీకృతమై ఉంటుంది, దాన్నే మనం న్యూక్లియస్ అంటాం. ఈ న్యూక్లియస్లో టోటల్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్, ఈ న్యూక్లియస్లో ఉన్నటువంటి పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ మొత్తం ఈ నెగిటివ్ చార్జ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ మొత్తం, దేర్ ఫర్ ఆటమ్ ఈజ్ ఓవరాల్ న్యూట్రల్. ఇక్కడ ఒక ఆటమ్, ఎవ్రీ ఆటమ్ ఈజ్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్లీ న్యూట్రల్, అంటే దాంట్లో ఎన్ని ధనావేశాలు ఉంటాయి అన్ని రుణావేశాలు ఉంటాయి, మొత్తం ఆటమ్ అనేది ఎలక్ట్రికల్లీ న్యూట్రల్. అండ్ సెంట్రిపిటల్ ఫోర్స్ రిక్వైర్డ్ బై ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫర్ రివాల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ ఈస్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ బై ద ఎలక్ట్రోస్టాటిక్ ఫోర్స్ ఆఫ్ అట్రాక్షన్ బిట్వీన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ అండ్ న్యూక్లియస్. హియర్ యూ నో దట్ ఇన్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ క్లాసెస్ యూ ఆల్రెడీ స్టడీడ్ ఎనీ బాడీ, ఇఫ్ ఎనీ బాడీ మూవింగ్ ఇన్ సర్క్యులర్ పాత్ ఇట్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ సెంట్రిపిటల్ ఫోర్స్. హియర్ అకార్డింగ్ టు రుదర్ఫోర్డ్ సైంటిస్ట్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ రివాల్వింగ్ అరౌండ్ ద న్యూక్లియస్ ఇన్ సర్క్యులర్ ఆర్బిట్స్ ఆన్ దట్ టైమ్ దట్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆల్సో ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ సెంట్రిపిటల్ ఫోర్స్. నౌ దట్ సెంట్రిపిటల్ ఫోర్స్ ఈస్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ బై ద ఎలక్ట్రోస్టాటిక్ ఫోర్స్ ఆఫ్ అట్రాక్షన్ బిట్వీన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ అండ్ న్యూక్లియస్. ఇన్ ఏ న్యూక్లియస్, న్యూక్లియస్ మీన్స్ వాట్, టోటల్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్, ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఇట్ కంటైన్స్ టోటల్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ ఆన్ ద టైమ్ దట్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ అట్రాక్టెడ్ బై ద ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్. అండ్ ఆల్సో నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ రుదర్ఫోర్డ్ ఆల్ఫా స్కాటరింగ్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్. హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ రేడియో యాక్టివ్ సోర్స్, ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ రేడియో యాక్టివ్ సోర్స్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్స్. హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ థిన్ గోల్డ్ ఫాయిల్, హియర్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్స్ స్ట్రైక్స్ ద గోల్డ్ ఫాయిల్ ఆన్ దట్ టైమ్ ఇట్ స్కాటర్డ్. హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద స్క్రీన్ ఆన్ ద టైమ్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్. హియర్ యాజ్ ద ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ మూవ్స్ విత్ ద కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఆన్ ద టైమ్ గోస్ ఆన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద బికాస్ ఆఫ్ రిపల్సివ్ ఫోర్స్ ఈ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ మొత్తం తగ్గి కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ టోటల్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ కన్వర్ట్ ఇన్ టు వాట్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఎనర్జీ ఆన్ ద టైమ్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్. ఎట్ ఏ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్, ఎట్ ఏ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద దిస్ గోల్డ్ ఫాయిల్ ఇయర్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ రీట్రేసెస్, సో దట్ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ వాట్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ ఆన్ ద టైమ్. డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ మీన్స్ వాట్, ఎట్ ఏ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద దిస్ గోల్డ్ ఫాయిల్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ, ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ టోటల్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ అపియర్స్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఎనర్జీ ఆన్ ద టైమ్ వీ హావ్ ఫార్ములా డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్. హియర్ హౌ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ దిస్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్? హియర్ ఆర్ నాట్, ఆర్ నాట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ వాట్ 1/4π0 2ZE² / EK. యాక్చువల్లీ హౌ వాట్ హ్యాపెండ్ హియర్, ఇక్కడ ఈ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ ఎలా వస్తుంది మనకి అంటే, ఇక్కడ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ కొంత కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీతో గోల్డ్ ఫాయిల్ వైపు పోతుంటుంది, అప్పుడు ఎట్ ఏ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ టోటల్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ అపియర్స్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఎనర్జీ, సో దట్ ఎట్ ఏ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ టోటల్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ కన్వర్ట్ ఇన్ టు పొటెన్షియల్ ఎనర్జీ, దట్ పర్టికులర్ డిస్టెన్స్నే మనం డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ అంటాం. ఇక్కడ ఆర్ నాట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు హౌ మచ్ 1/4π0 2ZE² / EK. నా ఈకే అంటే ఏంటి, కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ, ఆర్ నాట్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్, 4π0 ఈజ్ జెడ్ అటామిక్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ద టార్గెట్ ఈ ఛార్జ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్. సో ఈకే రిప్రజెంట్స్ ఫర్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ, కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్. సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ ఈజ్ ఇన్వర్స్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు మాస్. వాట్ ఈస్ ఈకే? కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ. కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ వాట్? కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు పొటెన్షియల్ ఎనర్జీ. కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఆఫ్ మచ్ ½mv² ½mv² ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు పొటెన్షియల్ ఎనర్జీ 1/4π0 ZE / E / r0. కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు పొటెన్షియల్ ఎనర్జీ. ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఇయర్ ఆల్ఫా పార్టికల్ ఎనర్జీ ఛార్జీస్ 2E, సో ఆన్ ద టైమ్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1/4π0 2ZE² / ½mv² ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ కైనెటిక్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఈజ్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా ఓన్లీ. హియర్ వాట్ ఈస్ వి? హియర్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఎమ్? మాస్. సో డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ ఈజ్ ఇన్వర్స్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు వాట్? మాస్. అండ్ ఇన్వర్స్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు వాట్ వి రైట్? కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ. హియర్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ ఈజ్ ఇన్వర్స్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు మాస్. దిస్ ఇస్ ప్రీవియస్ మెయిన్స్ ఎగ్జామ్ క్వశ్చన్ ఓన్లీ. అండ్ ఆల్సో నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ ఇంఫాక్ట్ పారామీటర్. ఇంఫాక్ట్ పారామీటర్ ఆన్ ద టైమ్. సో వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజెస్ట్ అప్రోచ్ హౌ మచ్? ఆర్ నాట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు హౌ మచ్? 1/4π0 2ZE² / EK. వాట్ ఈస్ జెడ్? జెడ్ ఈస్ ద అటామిక్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ టార్గెట్ ఎలిమెంట్ లైక్ గోల్డ్, And next one, we have impact parameter. What is impact parameter? It is the perpendicular distance of velocity vector of alpha particle from the central line of the nucleus. When the particle is far away from the nucleus, in alpha scattering experiment, here alpha particle moves towards the nucleus on the time. Perpendicular distance, impact parameter, what is that? It is the perpendicular distance of velocity vector of alpha particle. Velocity vector of alpha particle from the central line of the nucleus. When the particle is far away from the nucleus. When the particle is far away from the nucleus. Ikkada nucleus nunchi alpha particle duranga unnapudu aa velocity vector. Ikkada perpendicular distance of velocity vector from the alpha particle from the central line of the nucleus. When the nucleus is far away from the nucleus. Ante enti nucleus nunchi chaala duranga unnapudu aa central line ki ఈ వెలాసిటీ వెక్టార్కు ఉన్న పర్పెండిక్యులర్ డిస్టెన్స్నే మనం ఇంఫాక్ట్ పారామీటర్ అంటాం. ఇక్కడ ఇంఫాక్ట్ పారామీటర్ ఫార్ములా ఏంటి మనకి? బి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1/4π0 జడీ స్క్వేర్ కాట్ టీటా బై 2/ఈకే. వాట్ ఈస్ ఈకే? కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ. వాట్ ఈస్ జెడ్? అటామిక్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ న్యూక్లియస్. అండ్ టీటా, యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ స్కాటరింగ్. టీటా ఇస్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ స్కాటరింగ్. బి ఈజ్ డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ వాట్ కాట్ టీటా బై 2. అండ్ ఇన్వర్స్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ వాట్ వి రైట్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ. దిస్ ఈజ్ formula for impact parameter. So what is formula here? 1/4π0. 1/4π0 how much? 9 × 10⁻⁹ z, atomic number, e, charge of electron. What is charge of electron? 1.6 × 10⁻⁹ coulombs. E is 1.6 × 10⁻⁹ coulombs. You remember this? And next one, Rutherford scattering formula. According to this, n of theta means what? Number of alpha particles scattered is equal to ni × nt × z²e⁴. ni × nt × z²e⁴ by 8π₀²r²e²sin⁴θ/2. n of theta means what? Number of alpha particles scattered. N of theta represents what? Number of alpha particles scattered. ni represents what? Total number of alpha particles reach the screen. N is the number of atoms. Small n represents what? Number of atoms per unit volume in the foil. And T represents what? Here foil thickness. Z represents what? Atomic number here. And capital E represents what? Kinetic energy of alpha particle. By using this formula, we calculate number of alpha particles scattered. Number of alpha particles scattered. Here number of alpha particles scattered is inversely proportional to sin⁴θ/2. Remaining are constants. N of theta proportional to 1/sin⁴θ/2. This is the relation between scattering angle and number of alpha particles scattered. N of theta proportional to 1/sin⁴θ/2. So depends on this, we have problems. Limitations of Rutherford atomic model. Now, first of all, first limitation about stability of the atom. So, according to Maxwell's electromagnetic wave theory, and indeed Maxwell's vidyudayaskanta taranga niyama prakaram, electron should emit energy in the form of electromagnetic wave during its orbital motion. And idi orbital electron revolve avutunnappudu emit chestundi. Ikkada ee radiation anedi should emit energy. ఆ ఎనర్జీ అనేది శక్తిని మొత్తాన్ని విద్యుదయస్కాంత తరంగ రూపంలో విడుదల చేస్తుంది. అప్పుడు దెర్ఫోర్ రేడియస్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్బిట్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ విల్ డిక్రీస్. సో ఆర్బిటాల్ యొక్క వ్యాసార్థం తగ్గుతూ ఉంటుంది. అల్టిమేట్లీ ఇట్ ఫాల్స్ ఇన్ ద న్యూక్లియస్. అప్పుడు న్యూక్లియస్లో అది పడిపోతుంది. దిస్ ఈజ్ వన్ లిమిటేషన్. అండ్ ఆల్సో అబౌట్ ద లైన్ స్పెక్ట్రామ్, రుదర్ఫర్డ్ మోడల్ కెనాట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ అటామిక్ లైన్ స్పెక్ట్రామ్. ఈ రుదర్ఫర్డ్ మోడల్ డింట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ లైన్ స్పెక్ట్రామ్. Cannot explain atomic line spectrum. So these are the limitations of Rutherford model. And next we have Bohr's atomic model. Here according to Bohr scientist, electron can revolve in certain non-radiating orbits. Here electrons are revolving. Suppose this is the nucleus like this. Electrons can revolve in certain non-radiating orbits are called what? Stationary orbits. These are stationary orbits Now for which? Here angular momentum. Angular momentum is equal to what? NH by 2 pi. Here angular momentum is equal to NH by 2 pi. Here integral multiples of H by 2. Here angular momentum MVR is equal to what? NH by 2 pi. What is N here? Principal quantum number. N value of much? N is equal to how much? 1, 2, 3. For ground state how much? 1. Here N is equal to how much? N is the principal quantum number. And these are stationary orbits. Now in every orbit, what we take? Angular momentum is equal to what? Integral multiples of H by 2 pi. What is H here? Planck's constant. H represents Planck's constant. And also here, how radiation of energy occurs when an electron jumps from one orbit to another orbit. If the electron jumps from one permitted orbit to another permitted orbit, here radiation of energy occurs. So energy released, energy of emitted photon. If the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower energy level, on that time h nu is equal to what? E2 minus E1. What are E1, E2? E1, E2 are the energies of electron in orbits. Here, if the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower energy level, so on that time, this difference in energy levels appears in the form of photons. That's why energy of emitted photon how much? E2 minus E1, h nu. What is h nu? H is the Planck's constant. Nu represents what? Frequency. Here. So anyhow, according to Bohr's theory, electrons are revolving stationary orbits on the time. Here if the electron jumps from one orbit to another orbit, higher energy levels to lower energy level, like this. If the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower energy level, so on the time it radiates energy. On the time, difference in energy levels appears in the form of what? Photons. Energy of emitted photon. H nu. Here energy of photon is H nu. H nu is equal to what? E2 minus E1. What are E1, E2? E1, E2 are the energies of electrons in orbits. And also we discuss radius of orbit of electron. Here, I think you already studied in IP regular syllabus. Here directly I am explaining formulas only. So compulsory remember these formulas. If you want to do problems, compulsory remember formulas like tables. Meeku formulas anni meeku tables laga vastune meeku problems vastuntai. So that's why you remember formulas. Here suppose for this also we have derivation. So in regular classes already chadivi untaru. Ikkada nenu derivations em cheppatledu, meeku direct formulas cheptuna. So gurtu pettukondi, direct remember. Now radius of orbit of electron. Here radius of orbit of electron, how much we are getting? N square h square by 4 pi square m k z e square. What is k? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. From this r proportional to how much? N square by z. Radius of orbit of electron how much? R proportional to n square z. R proportional to n square by z. What is n? Principal quantum number. Z, atomic number. Here given already, n is principal quantum number, h is Planck's constant. What is m here? Mass of electron. K value of much? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. What is the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 is equal to 9 into 10 to the power of 9. And z is atomic number. E represents what? Electron charge. So anyhow, radius of orbit of electron how much? R proportional to n square z. Here n value increases, radius increases. And also velocity of electron in any orbit. Velocity of electron how much? V is equal to how much? 2 pi kz e square by nh. Here same, k is 1 by 4 by epsilon 0, z is atomic number. So here velocity is directly proportional to what? Z by n. Here this is formula for what? Velocity of electron in any orbit. Here for every orbit n value changes. So z is the atomic number. So velocity proportional to what? Z by n. Velocity proportional to z by n. And also we have frequency of electron in any orbit. Frequency how much here? kz e square by nhr. K is nothing but what? 4 pi epsilon 0. So from this we substitute like this: we are getting frequency. First we discuss frequency, after that energy. Frequency proportional to what we are getting? Z square by n cube. Frequency proportional to how much we are getting? Z square by n cube. What is Z here? Atomic number. Again n is principal quantum number, m. M represents what? Here h represents what? Planck's constant. M mass. So anyhow, frequency. Frequency proportional to Z square by n cube. Frequency proportional to Z square by n cube. Remaining all are constants. Here n, principal quantum number. What is h? Planck's constant. So Z is, so m mass, k is 1 by 4 by epsilon 0. Anyhow, frequency proportional to how much? Z square by n cube. Kinetic energy of electron in any orbit. What is formula for kinetic energy? Half mv square. So kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. So we substitute v value. So we are getting on the time. Kinetic energy is equal to how much we are getting? 2 pi square mu to the power of 4 z square k square by n square h square. Here what is z? Atomic number, k is 1 by 4 by epsilon 0. So on that substituting constant values, we are getting 13.6 z square by n square electron volts. Here kinetic energy, how much kinetic energy of electron is? 13.6 z square by n square electron volts. In the same way, potential energy. Electron is revolving in circular orbit because of its position. Here, you know that potential energy, energy possessed by a body by virtue of its position. So on that time it experiences potential energy. Potential energy is minus 27.2 z square by n square electron volts. So potential energy proportional to z square by n square. Potential energy also proportional to z square by n square. Here kinetic energy also proportional to z square by n square. But here potential energy, kinetic energy is equal to what? Double. Kinetic energy is equal to what? Double the potential energy is equal to what we write? Double the kinetic energy. But it is negative. Potential energy is always negative. And total energy. Total energy becomes what? Minus 13.6 z square by n square. Here what is difference between total energy and kinetic energy? Sign only different. Kinetic energy is positive and potential energy is negative. So on the time, here what we write now? Here potential energy is equal to Ep is equal to minus of 2 times of kinetic energy. Potential energy is equal to how much? Minus of 2 times of kinetic energy. Now total energy. Total energy is equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy. So on the time, total energy is equal to potential energy of how much? Minus here. Potential energy is minus 2 kinetic energy plus kinetic energy. So total energy is equal to minus of kinetic energy. Here kinetic energy is equal to minus of total energy. Kinetic energy is equal to what we write? Minus of total energy. And kinetic energy is equal to how much? Potential energy by 2. Kinetic energy is equal to minus of potential energy by 2. Kinetic energy is equal to minus of potential energy by 2. And kinetic energy is equal to what we write? Minus of total energy. By using these formulas we calculate energy. And also next one we have, here already I explained that according to Bohr's theory, if the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower energy level, so on that time here difference in energy levels appears in the form of what? Photons. It emits radiations. So on that time if the electron jumps from higher energy state to lower energy state, N2 to N1, on the time, here 1 by lambda, 1 by lambda is equal to how much? Here 2 pi square, we are equating difference in energy levels, so on the time 1 by lambda is equal to, we are getting 2 pi square into mk square e to the power of 4 z square by ch cube into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. Now this is constant R, Rydberg constant, so its value of much? 1.097 into 10 to the power of 7 meter inverse. So by using this formula we calculate wavelength of emitted radiation. If the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower energy level, so difference in energy levels appeared in the form of electromagnetic radiation, photon of a wavelength of much? Lambda. Now here from this formula we calculate wavelength, and next we discuss hydrogen spectrum series. Here already I explained now. Suppose in case of hydrogen, here each element emits a spectrum of radiation which is characteristics of element itself. Here it is the characteristic property of element. Now spectrum consists of set of isolated parallel lines is called what? Line spectrum. Here we have different energy levels on the time. We are getting, look here. Now, so first of all n is equal to 1. If the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower energy level, so if the n is equal to 2, n2 is equal to 2, n1 is equal to 1 on the time. If the electron jumps from higher energy level to ground state, n is equal to 1, on that time we are getting Lyman series of spectral lines. Lyman series of spectral line. Otherwise, n1 is equal to 2, n2 is equal to 3, 4, 5 and so on, we are getting Balmer series of spectral lines. And also n1 is equal to 3, n2 is equal to 4, 5, 6, we are getting Fashion series of spectral lines and Brocket series. N1 is equal to 4, n2 is equal to what, 5, 6, 7 and so on, we are getting Brocket. And also in the same way, n1 is equal to 5, n2 is equal to what, 6, 7, 8 and on that time we are getting Fund series of spectral lines. Now, here, that only given here, hydrogen spectrum contains what, 5 series of spectral lines, Lyman series. When electron jumps from what, n is equal to 2, 3, 4 orbit to what, n is equal to 1 orbit. N is equal to 1 means what, that is ground state. N is equal to 1 means what, ground state. Here, first excited state means what, n1, n2 is 2. Here, n value is 2, first excited state, n1 value almost 2, ground state means what, 1. If the electron jumps from higher energy level to ground state, so on that time we are getting Lyman series of spectral lines. Now this series is lies in ultraviolet region, UV region. After that Balmer series, electron jumps from what? N2 is equal to what? 3, 4, 5, 2 orbit to N2, N1 is equal to what? Second orbit, 2. Then a line of Balmer series is formed. This series lies in what? Visual region. And next we have here, Fashion series. If the electron jumps from N2 is equal to 4, 5, 6 orbit to N2, N1 is equal to 3, then a line of Fashion series is obtained. Now the series lies in what? Infrared region. Next we have Brocket series. Electron jumps from what? N2 is equal to 5, 6, 7 orbit to N is equal to 4 orbit. Then a line of Brocket series is formed. Now the series lies in what? Infrared region. And next we have last one, Fund series. Fund series means what? When an electron jumps from N is equal to what? 6, 7, 8 orbit to what? N is equal to 5 orbit. Then a line of Fund series is obtained. So depends on these formulas, here we have problems. Now we discuss some problems. First question. Now, what is that? Find the largest and shortest wavelengths in the Lyman series for hydrogen. Lyman series, find the largest and shortest wavelengths. Largest and shortest wavelengths in the Lyman series for hydrogen. In what region electromagnetic spectrum does each series lies? Here, largest, we want to calculate largest wavelength. Here, when we are getting Lyman series, when we are getting N1 value is 1, N2 is equal to what, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to infinity. Now, when we are getting shortest wavelength, if the electron jumps from what? Here, now we want to calculate what? Largest wavelength and shortest wavelength. Both wavelengths we calculate. Here, transition equation for Lyman series. What is the formula? 1 by lambda is equal to what? R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N square. What is R here? Rydberg constant. N value how much for Lyman series? N1 is 1, N2 how much? N. N value how much? 2, 3, 4 and so on. Here, largest wavelength. When we are getting largest wavelength, N1 is 1, N2 how much? 2. So 2 square, N2 is 2, so on that time we are getting largest wavelength. So on that time Rydberg constant value is constant. What is it? 1.097 into 10 to the power 7. 1 by N1 square, N1 how much? 1. For Lyman series N1 value how much? 1, N2 value how much? 2. So if N2, if the electron jumps from second orbit to first orbit, N2 is equal to 2, 2, N2, N1 is equal to 1, we are getting largest wavelength. So on that time how much we are getting here? What is LCM here? 4, 4 minus 1 how much? 3 by 4. We are simplifying, we are getting like this. How much? 12, 15 angstroms. This is the largest wavelength. And also we calculate shortest wavelength. When we are getting shortest wavelength, if the electron jumps from a orbit, N value how much? Infinity. Infinity to 1. N1 is equal to 1, N2 is equal to what? Infinity. On that time we are getting shortest wavelength. Same formula. 1 by lambda is equal to how much? R into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. N1 is 1, n2 is equal to how much? We are taking infinity. When? For shortest wavelength. Now substituting 1 by infinity how much? Something by infinity how much? 0. So 1 minus 0 here. 1 minus 0 how much? 1 only. So on the time we are getting 1 by lambda minimum is 1.097. Lambda minimum how much? Reverse this. So we are getting 911 angstroms. So in case of Lyman series, shortest wavelength is 911, largest wavelength how much? 1215. Remaining wavelengths all are lies between what? In between minimum and maximum. Minimum how much? 911. Maximum how much? 1215 angstroms. Here both of these wavelengths where lie in ultraviolet region of electromagnetic spectrum. Ultraviolet region of electromagnetic spectrum. Next question. Here using the known values of hydrogen atom. Using the known values of hydrogen atom, we calculate radius of third orbit of Li plus 2 and speed of electron in fourth orbit for He plus. We want to calculate radius and speed of electron. We have two questions. How we calculate? Using the known values of hydrogen atom. Known values of hydrogen atom, we calculate first question radius and next one speed of electron. For lithium, Z value how much? 3. Further, we know Rn is equal to how much? N square by Z into A naught. According to hydrogen, here what is the radius of hydrogen? A naught. Now, A naught value how much? 0.529 angstroms. 0.529 or 0.53 angstroms. Now, for lithium, here Z value how much? 3. N value how much? 3. That's why we substitute now. Here R3 for lithium, radius how we calculate? N square by Z. N value of much 3, 3 square by Z, 3 into A naught of much 0.529. Yeah, 3 square by 3, so 3 into 0.529. We are getting answer of much 1.587. Here you remember radius of hydrogen of much A naught value of much 0.529 angstroms. Radius of hydrogen is 0.529 angstroms. What is formula for radius of nth orbit? Rn is equal to how much? n square a naught by z. What is n? Principal quantum number. Z value, what is z? Atomic number. So on that time R3 how much we are getting? 1.587 angstroms. And also we calculate velocity. How we calculate? For helium atomic number how much? Z. Also we know that Vn is equal to how much? z by n into v1. Here n value how much? For helium, n value is 4, z is equal to 2, v1, this also constant. For hydrogen, here v1 is equal to almost 2.19 into 10 to the power of 6. So, on that time, for helium, v4, He plus is equal to 2 by 4, z, for helium, z value how much? Atomic number 2, and n value how much? 4. So, 2 by 4 into v1 value how much? 2.19 into 10 to the power of 6. You remember this value. For hydrogen, here, V1 value almost 2.19 into 10 to the power of 6. So 2 by 4, 1 by 2, we are getting answer 1.095 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second. We have question. A monochromatic light source of frequency illuminates a metallic surface, ejects photoelectrons. Here the photoelectrons having maximum energy are just able to ionize the hydrogen atom in ground state. Now what is the when the whole experiment is repeated with an incident radiation of frequency how much? 5 by 6 times of f. Now the photoelectrons are emitted. We able to excite the hydrogen atom beam, which then emits a radiation of wavelength how much? 1215 angstroms. We want to calculate frequency of radiation and work function. You know work function. What is work function? Energy required to liberate the electron from the metal surface. Now we want to calculate frequency of radiation. Here, how we calculate now? Using Einstein equations for photoelectric effects. What is Einstein photoelectric equation? Kinetic energy is equal to what? Incident energy minus work function. Maximum kinetic energy how much? 13.6. So on that time, here HF minus W is equal to what? 13.6. Now first equation. Now but frequency. Here how much frequency illuminated here? 5F by 6 minus W. How much radiation we are getting? Wavelength 1215. We are getting 10.2 electron volts. Now solving equations 1 and 2. We are getting HF by 6 is equal to 3 by 4. From this we calculate frequency. Here, first of all, maximum kinetic energy how much? 13.6. That's why HF minus W is equal to how much we are taking? 13.6. After that, it is illuminated with a frequency. How much here? 5F by 6. So on that, how much given here wavelength? Wavelength given 1215. Already given in problem 1215. So how much we are getting? 10.2. Now solving equations 1 and 2. So we are getting HF by 6 is equal to 3.4. We substitute now here F value. 6 into 3.4 electron volt. 1 electron volt is equal to how many joules? Here 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. 1 electron volt is equal to how much? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. We are getting frequency, how much we are getting? 4.92 into 10 to the power of 15. You remember this. 1 electron volt is equal to how many joules? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. And also we calculate work function. Same, according to Einstein photoelectric equation, work function is equal to what? HF minus 13.6. Work function from first equation, work function is equal to what? HF minus 13.6. H value how much? Planck's constant, how much we are taking? 6. Here, from this, energy how much? Here, frequency how much we got? Here, frequency how much? Here, 3.4 minus 13.6. So total how much we are getting? 6.8 electron volts. 6.8 electron volts. In this way we calculate work function and what is that? Work function and frequency. Frequency of incident, frequency of radiation how much we are getting? 4.92 into 10 to the power of 15. Next question. We have hydrogen like atom of atomic number Z is in an excited state of quantum number 2n. It can emit a maximum energy of photon how much? 204 electron volts. If it makes a transition to quantum state n, a photon of energy 40.8 electron volt is emitted. Now find n, z and ground state energy for this atom. We want to calculate n. N means what? Principal quantum number. Z atomic number. And the ground state of energy for this atom. We want to calculate energy in electron volts. Also calculate the minimum energy in electron volts that can emitted by this atom during the excitation. Ground state of hydrogen atom how much? 13.6. Here we want to calculate N, Z and ground state energy. N means what? Principal quantum number. Z means what? Atomic number. And ground state energy. And also what we calculate? Minimum energy. Now how we calculate? Here first of all in solution, how much energy given here? 204 electron volts is given. According to our theory, energy in a orbit. Energy in a orbit, what wave formula? 13.6 z square by n square. So for first excited state, n value is equal to how much? 1. Now 2n square, 2n. So that's why 2n whole square is 204. So e2n minus en how much? 40.8 given. So e2n how much we are taking? 1 by n square minus 1 by 2n whole square. We are getting 40.8. Now solving equations 1 and 2. Solving equations 1 and 2. So 204 given and 40.8 also given. So now solving equations 1 and 2. We are getting here energy, first excited state. Here ground state energy how much? First of all what we are getting? N is equal to 2 and Z is equal to how much? 4. Atomic number is 4, N value is 2. So we are getting energy. Energy how much? 217.6 electron volts. Now during de-excitation, minimum energy emitted. Minimum energy emitted how much? E minimum is equal to how much? E2n minus E2n minus 1. So E4 minus E3. E4 minus E3 what we write? E2n minus E2n minus 1. We substitute now. We are getting 10.58 electron volts. Next question. Here, light from a discharge tube containing hydrogen atom falls on the surface of a piece of sodium. Kinetic energy of fastest here photoelectrons emitted from sodium is given. Here work function also given. Now we want to calculate energy of photon causing the photoelectric emission. Quantum numbers of two levels involved in the emission of these electrons and change in angular momentum. Change in angular momentum of electron in the hydrogen atom in the above transition. Here recoil speed of emitting electrons. Recoil speed of emitting atom assuming it to be rest for before transition. Take mass of hydrogen how much? 1.6 into 10 to the power of 27 kg. Here you know that in Bohr's model you already studied. Here angular momentum is equal to what? Nh by 2 pi. Here energy of photons causing photoelectric emission. So energy of photon, how much? H nu. Here kinetic energy given, work function also given. So energy of kinetic energy of fastest electrons given and work function also given. So how we calculate energy? Energy is equal to how much? According to Einstein photoelectric equation, here work function plus kinetic energy and quanta number we calculate. First we calculate kinetic energy given. What is kinetic energy here? 0.73. Work function how much? 1.82. Now how we are getting energy? According to Einstein photoelectric equation, what is that? Kinetic energy of a photon is equal to what? Maximum kinetic energy plus work function. Maximum kinetic energy how much? 0.73 plus work function 1.82. How much we are getting now? 2.55 electron volts. 2.55 electron volts. And also we want to calculate quantum levels involved. How we calculate now? What is formula for energy of electron in nth orbit? En is equal to what? 13.6 by n square electron volts for hydrogen atom. Now E1 how much? N is equal to, we take 1. So n is equal to, we take 1. E1 how much? Minus 13.6. N is equal to, we take 2. 2 square 4. 4 means what? 4 3 is 4 fourths. So E2 is minus 3.4. So and E3 how much? 3 square. 3 square means what? 9. So 13.6 by 9 how much? 1.51. And E4 how much? 0.85. Now clearly E4 minus E2 how much? E4 how much? 0.85 minus E2 how much? Minus 3.4. What we are getting? 2.55. So that's why quantum energy levels. Here energy of photon how much? Energy of photon is 2.55. That's why quantum levels involved how much here? 4 and 2. Quantum levels involved how much? 4 and 2. How we decide? Here we calculate difference in energy levels. What is energy of photon? Energy of photon is 2.55. So when we are getting photon here from, if the electron jumps from what? Fourth state to second state. So that's why quantum levels involved. How much here? 4 and 2. And also we calculate angular momentum. How we calculate angular momentum? According to Bohr's model, here angular momentum L is equal to what? Nh by 2 pi. Mvr is equal to what? Nh by 2 pi. According to that, here L4 minus L2, change in momentum. So for fourth year, L is equal to L4 minus L2. For second orbit, here what we take here? 2. Now, n value, how much? Principal quantum number? 2 means what? First excited state, so 2. Next one. Here L is equal L4 minus L2, so what we take? 4H by 2 pi minus 2H by 2 pi. Here what we take now? 4 minus 2, 2, 2H by 2 pi, so we are getting H by pi. Here change in angular momentum, how much? H by pi. And linear momentum. Linear momentum, how we calculate? Momentum, E by C. Here, momentum is equal to how much? E by C. Here, how we are getting this? According to Einstein mass energy relation, E is equal to how much? Mc square. E is equal to mc square. So it is nothing but E mc into c. So E is equal to p into c. Now p is equal to how much? E by c. Here momentum. Momentum is equal to what? P is equal to what? E by c. Already we know energy. Energy how much we got? We calculate. How much we got? Energy of photon 2.55. 2.55 electron volts. 1 electron volt is equal to how many joules? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 by C. C how much? 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. So we are simplifying. We are getting how much? 1.36 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg meter per second. Now we want to calculate here recoil speed of hydrogen atom. Here, how we calculate? Suppose V is the recoil speed of hydrogen atom of mass m. So from conservation of linear momentum. Momentum is P is equal to what? Mv. So velocity is equal to what? P by M. P how much? Momentum. Momentum how much we got? 1.36 into 10 to the power of minus 27 and mass. Mass how much? 1.6. Given mass of hydrogen, here 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 27. So we are getting how much? 0.85 meter per second. 0.85 meter per second. So in this way, we calculate change in angular momentum and quantum levels and also recoil velocity. Find the ratio of longest wavelengths corresponding to Lyman and Balmer series of hydrogen spectrum. hydrogen spectrum or hydrogen spectra. Longest wavelength, here we want to calculate ratio of lambda L by lambda bomber. These are longest wavelength. Longest wavelength means what? Maximum wavelength. When we are getting maximum wavelength for Lyman series, for maximum wavelength for Lyman series, here for Lyman series, for Lyman series, for Lyman series, N1 is equal to, we take 1, N2 is equal to almost 2. For Balmer series, for Balmer series, N1 is equal to almost 2, N2 is equal to 3. Here we know that in a hydrogen spectra you already studied, what is formula for wavelength? 1 by lambda is equal to how much we write? 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. 1 by lambda is equal to how much? R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. From this, yeah, first of all, we want to calculate longest wavelengths. Longest wavelengths. So, for Lyman series, what we take? N1 is equal to 1, N2 is equal to 2. If you take N2 is equal to infinity, we are getting shortest wavelength. But we require ratio of longest wavelengths. So, N2 is equal to how much? We are taking 2. For Balmer series, N1 is equal to almost 2, N2 is equal to almost 3. So, from this, 1 by lambda proportional to 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. From this, for Lyman series, here for Lyman series, what we write? Here 1 by lambda L by 1 by lambda Balmer is equal to 1 by N1 square, 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 2 square by 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 3 square. From this, 1 by lambda L by 1 by lambda Balmer. So, we are getting lambda Balmer by lambda Lyman. We are getting, what is LCM here? 1 by 2 square means what? 1 by 4. 1 minus 1 by 4 by 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. Here, what we are getting? LCM. 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1 by 4. Here, LCM how much? 36. So, 9 minus 4 by 4, 9 is 36. So, from this, 4 minus 1 how much? 3 by 4. 3 by 4 into 36 by 9 minus 4, 5. So, from this, 4 ones, 4 nines. 9 threes how much? 27. 27 by 5. This is the ratio of here lambda Balmer by lambda Lyman. But lambda here Lyman by lambda Balmer how much? Longest wavelengths. 5 by 27. Here from this we are getting answer. Lambda Lyman by Balmer is equal to 5 by 27. A particle of charge Q. Particle of charge Q and mass m performs uniform circular motion like this. Suppose r be the radius. Now, particle of mass m and charge Q performs uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion like this. It rotates like this. So, L and capital M. Capital L and M are angular momentum and magnetic moment. Angular momentum, you know that if any body moving in a circular path, it experiences what? Angular momentum and magnetic moment. Magnetic moment. How we calculate now? Angular momentum, what is that? We want to calculate L by M. So, angular momentum how much? Angular momentum L is equal to how much? MVR. Suppose R be the radius. First you write, let R be the radius of circular path. Here, what is R here? Let R be the radius of circular path. Radius of circular path. And V be the velocity. Here, V be the velocity. On the time, angular momentum how much? MVR. And also, V be the velocity. Here, we are taking V be the velocity. V, let R be the radius and V be the velocity. Angular momentum how much? MVR. Magnetic moment. How we calculate magnetic moment? Magnetic moment of charge. Here you know that magnetic moment of revolving electron, EVR by 2. How we are getting that? Magnetic moment means what? I into A. Magnetic moment is equal to here I into A. What is unit of magnetic moment? Ampere meter square. So what is formula for magnetic moment? Ampere. So I into A. I how much here? Charge. Here I is equal to what we write? Q by T. Q by T. Now area how much? Pi r square. So T time period. Time period how much here? For one revolution how much distance traveled here? Circumference 2 pi r by V. So from this here T is equal to 2 pi r by V. T is equal to 2 pi r by V. According to this, M is equal to Q by T. T is 2 pi r by V into pi r square. So from this, r r gets cancelled. Pi pi gets cancelled. So we are getting V comes to numerator. Magnetic moment becomes Q V r by 2. Magnetic moment becomes Q V r by 2. Here from this, we calculate L by M value. L how much? M V r. L by M is equal to M V r by, how much we are getting magnetic moment? Q V r by 2. So V V gets cancelled. So we are getting 2 M by Q. 2 comes to numerator. What is the answer now? 2 M by Q. What is M here? Mass. What is Q? Charge. So this only ratio of L and M. L by M value of mass. 2 M by Q. In this way we calculate. Here we have question. What is given question? Ground state energy of hydrogen atom is given 13.6 electron volts. If the when its electron is in first excited state, find its excitation energy. Find its excitation energy. Here excitation energy means what? Energy required to excite the from ground state to higher energy levels. Excitation energy means what? Energy required to excite the electron from ground state to higher energy state. That is called what? Excitation energy. Excitation energy. First of all, in ground state how much given? E1 is 13.6 electron volts. Now, when its electron is in first excited state means what? N value how much? 2. N1 is equal to 1. N2 is equal to how much? 2. First excited state. Now, so on that time E2 value how much? They are asking its excitation energy. Its excitation energy. So, excitation energy. Here, let it be delta E. Let it be delta E. How we calculate now? Here we calculate energy in second excited state also. Energy, we calculate energy in first excited state. How we calculate now? E2. E2 value of much? Here we have formula minus 13.6 by N2 square. Hydrogen. So E2 value of much? Minus 13.6 by N2 square. From this, minus 13.6 by N2 value of much? 2. 2 square. So minus 13.6 by 4. How much are getting now? 4 ones, 4 threes, 12, 16, 4 fours. We are getting minus 3.4. Minus 3.4. On that time, excitation energy. How we calculate now? E2 minus E1. What is excitation energy? Energy required to excite the electron from ground state to higher energy states. So here, electron is in first excited state. That's why excitation energy, how we calculate now? Delta E. Delta E is equal to E2 minus E1. E2 value of much? Minus 3.4 minus 13.6. Now from this, here minus 3.4 plus 13.6. Subtract now. 6 minus 4, 2, 19 minus... 6 minus 4, 2, 13 minus 3, 10. So 10.2 electron volts. 10.2 electron volt is the excitation energy of the excitation energy of electron. So this only answer. What is given question? Energy levels of ABC of a certain atom corresponding to increasing values of energy. increasing values of energy, EABEC. Now, here lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 are the wavelengths of radiation corresponding to our transitions from C to B, B to A, and C to A. Now, we take like this. Now, this is C, now this is B, this is A. Now, ABC, here ABC, like this. Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 are wavelengths corresponding to our transitions from C to B, like this, C to B, and B to A, B to A, and C to A, like this. Here, what we are getting? C to B, here, C to B is lambda 1, and B to A is lambda 2, and here, what we have wavelength here? Lambda 3. Now, this is lambda 3. Now this is lambda 3. We want to derive relation between lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. Here, you already studied Bohr's model. According to Bohr's model, if the electron jumps from higher energy level to lower energy level, so difference in energy levels appears in the form of what? Energy. Appears in the form of electromagnetic waves or radiations of wavelengths how much? Lambda. So, on the time, here electron jumps from what? C to A, we are getting wavelength of radiation of wavelength lambda 3. If the electron jumps from C level to B level, we are getting lambda 1, and B level to A level, we are getting lambda 2. That is why here we want to derive relationship between what? Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. So, what we write now? Here delta C, delta ECA is equal to delta E CB plus delta E BA. So, according to this, delta E CA how much? Here, difference in energy levels appears in the form of electromagnetic radiations. So, what we write now directly? HC by lambda 3. HC by lambda 3. Electron jumps from C to A. C to A how much radiation wavelength emitted? Wavelength of radiation how much? Lambda 3. So, that is why HC by lambda 3, here HC by C to B, C to B how much? Lambda 1. Again, B to A how much? We are getting lambda 2, HC by lambda 2. From this, here we take HC, we take common, we are getting 1 by lambda 1 plus 1 by lambda 2. From this, HC gets cancelled. We are getting here 1 by lambda 3 is equal to how much? We are getting 1 by lambda 1 plus 1 by lambda 3. From this, we are getting 1 by lambda 3 is equal to how much? 1 by lambda 1 plus 1 by lambda 2. This is the relationship between lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda 3. Otherwise, by taking LCM, what we are getting? 1 by lambda 3, lambda 1 plus what is LCM? Lambda 1, lambda 2, we are getting lambda 2 plus lambda 1. So, on that time, lambda 3 value how much we are getting? Here, lambda 3 is equal to lambda 1, lambda 2 by lambda 1 plus lambda 2. This is also okay, this is also correct. 1 by lambda 3 how much? 1 by lambda 1 plus 1 by lambda 2. Otherwise, we write lambda 3 is equal to how much? Lambda 1, lambda 2 by lambda 1 plus lambda 2.